Hi guys, happy Thursday. I'm coming to you from my front yard. It's such a beautiful day, so I thought I'd sit outside and enjoy the sunshine. I want to remind you guys that we have a Zoom meeting at 1 today, and I want to go over some of our class Zoom rules. Rule number one, listen to the person speaking. Keep your mic turned off until it's your turn. Number two, raise your hand to speak and the teacher will unmute you. Number three, stay in your seat unless I ask you to get up. For example, today we're going to be doing a scavenger hunt, so obviously you're going to need to get up to go get things for the scavenger hunt. But if you're not doing something like that, stay in your seat, because last time some of you guys were moving around a lot and it was getting me kind of dizzy, so stay in your seat. And number four, same dress code as school. And I'm going to strongly encourage you change out of your PJs. I try to change out of my PJs every day. I mean, I don't dress super fancy, but I do wear like my workout clothes because it just helps it feel more like a normal day and you're not just being lazy. It helps you work harder, I think, if you're wearing normal clothes and not PJs. And number five, make sure you have a parent nearby watching you. And number six, as always, be kind. I want to tell you guys about how the scavenger hunt is going to work. So I'm going to read the card and you'll need to go get something from your house. For example, I'm going to say, go find something green. And then you're going to go get something green walking. And then, for example, I have a green pen. So I'm going to hold it up to the camera so everybody can see. And then, like I said, safely, no running, get your item, bring it back, hold it close to the camera, and then when it's time to get the next item, you're going to put away wherever you found your last item, and then get your next item. And I want you guys to be good sports. We're just playing for fun. There's no, like, winners or losers, so just doing it for fun. So we'll see how it goes, and hopefully you guys have a good time doing that. When you are done with your packet pages for today, I want you to please look at the online resources that I made for early finishers. I used a lot of these resources with my second graders last year. I especially like the language arts resources, Epic, RazKids, and Lexia. I used all those with my second graders, and those would be great resources for you guys to use to get you ready for second grade. You can either download the app on your iPad or on your phone, or you can go to the website on a computer. And then for math, I really like Extra Math. I did that one with my second graders every day. That will be a great way for you guys to get ready for second grade, practice those addition and subtraction skills. And I want to let you know that with the online resources, I can see when you sign in and I can see what you've been doing. So I definitely want to shout out the kids that have been going on Epic and RazKids and Extra Math. Thank you. I want to see more kids going on those websites and doing extra work. All right, guys, work hard, be nice, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye. All right, let's go through the packet pages that I have assigned for today. So for language arts, you're doing page 185. Don't forget your name and number at the top on every page. It says, some words help readers see, hear, feel, taste, or smell. These words are called sensory words, and they can also be called adjectives. So they're words that describe something. So, for example, a dark night, a spicy meal, a sweet rose, a quiet tap, or a sticky spill. It says, read the sentence, underline the sensory word. The day is sunny. Okay, sunny describes the day, so you're gonna underline that. And then do the rest, do 2, 3, and 4 on your own. Underline those describing words that describe how you might see, hear, feel, taste, or smell. For handwriting practice, again, don't forget your name and number at the top. You're going to practice your capital R and lowercase r, so don't forget to follow the arrows exactly the way they tell you to. Trace all the letters and then practice writing them on your own, starting at the dot. And then do the same thing for lowercase r, follow the arrows the way they tell you to, trace all the r's, and then do them yourself. And don't forget to do the bottom as well. For math today, you're going to do page 172, number 18. After you write your name and number at the top, do number 18. It says, there are 12 boys and girls on the bus. How many boys and girls can there be? Choose all possible answers. Okay, there's 12 boys and girls total. So what I want you to do is go through all of these and see which numbers equal 12. So 14 plus 2, that doesn't equal 12, so you're not going to select that one. 2 plus 10, that does equal 12. So go through the rest and see which other ones equal 12.
For science, I want you to reread this article, How Do Living Things Get Food in a Desert? When you're done rereading the article, I want you to get out a blank piece of paper, lined paper preferably, and I want you to answer this question. What did you learn about desert animals? Don't forget the date, a title, the question, and I want at least 4 sentences about what you learned. Don't forget your neat handwriting. Don't forget to start your sentences with capitals and end them with periods. All right, that's all I have for the packet pages today.